Hello everyone, today I will talk about BGT Common Base Amplifier, its DC and its AC analysis, and the total response will be the summation of DC and AC. I mean we will apply a signal from emitter side, a small signal from emitter side like this, and it will be amplified and swing around the DC value like this. Sorry, my driving, it will be like this. Okay, this value is V output DC. This is V input. We call it common base because we apply input at the emitter side and take the output at the collector side. So base will be common. Let's make the DC analysis. Remember, when we make DC analysis, capacitors are open circuited. Capacitors are open circuited. And open circuit means there will be no current passing through. So there will be no current passing through this side. There will be no current passing through this side and also this side. So my circuit in DC case becomes like this. So, remember the last time when we investigate the common emitter case, we looked at here and write the V Thevenin and R Thevenin to simplify the circuit. Remember, V Thevenin equals V open circuit. So, if I cut the connection here and look at the V open circuit, what will I see here? This voltage will be voltage divider voltage, so V Thevenin equals R2 over R1 plus R2 times VCC. When we look at R Thevenin, remember, when we look equivalent R Thevenin resistance, we again look at here R Thevenin, but we make DC sources shut down it. I mean, we make voltage DC sources grounded or independent voltage sources short circuited, independent current sources open circuited, and then, sorry guys, and then we here, this is R2, and then we connect a V-test voltage. V-test over I-test will give me the Thevenin resistance, and here this is simply equals R1 parallel R2. Why? Because current has two paths to go to ground. So my circuit in DC analysis becomes this. This is V Thevenin. Okay, right now we can write KVL equation here. So V Thevenin minus base current times R Thevenin minus. Here there is a voltage drop VBE, and generally it is given in the question. It is forward bias PN junction voltage drop 0.6 or 0.7. Generally it is given in the question, and beta value also given in the question. So let's take it as 0.6. So we subtract 0.6, also emitter current beta plus 1 times IB is emitter current times RE equals 0. I just wrote the KVL equation. So what is, so we can find, if we rearrange this, IB current becomes V Thevenin minus 0.6, R Thevenin plus beta plus 1 times RE becomes my base current. If I know the base current, I can find the collector current simply by the relation of this. Collector current equals beta times IB, and emitter current is the summation of the collector current and the base current. So my DC analysis is done. So how can jump from DC analysis to AC analysis, remember. The important parameter here, GM. GM was IC over VT. What is VT? VT is thermal voltage. What is thermal voltage? We calculate its value by KT over Q. Here K Boltzmann constant, here T temperature and Q is the clamp, our charge. So in room temperature, its value is like 25 millivolt or 26 millivolt. Okay, and we just calculated the IC value, so we can calculate the GM. So right now we can pass to AC analysis. Okay, so my circuit in AC analysis, remember, when we make AC analysis, the first thing we do is we short circuit the capacitors, here capacitors, and here arrow symbol means ground. This arrow symbol means ground, and we also ground the DC voltage sources. So here R1 is between two ground, there will be no current passing through. R2 is between two ground, there will be no current passing through in AC analysis. So simply base will be connected to ground in AC analysis. Okay, so if we draw the small signal equivalent of common base amplifier, it will be like this. Base is connected to ground. Here base. Here there is RP. Remember the value of RP. It was beta force over GM. Right now be careful. Here there is R emitter. And V input connected from here. So this current is IB. And here beta times IB current comes in. So this current is beta plus 1 times IB. And here I input current will come in. And the summation will pass through RE. And see that V emitter equals V input. Let's first find the R input. What is R input? R input simply V input over I input. So we know that V input equals V emitter. Okay. How can write V input? Look at here. V input equals minus IB times beta force over GM. Okay. What is I input? I input equals V input over RE minus beta plus 1 times IB. And simply we replace V input here, this value upper side. So I input becomes minus IB times beta force over GM over RE here minus beta plus 1 times IB. Okay, I will now neglect the 1 here because beta is like 100 and we can neglect the 1. So I input right now, I will take IB times beta force parentheses. So minus 1 over RE times GM minus 1 is my I input. So this is my I input value, and also I know the V input value here. If I divide them, I will find the R input value. So let's divide it. R input equals minus IB times beta force over GM divided by IB times beta force minus 1 over RE GM minus 1. Sorry guys. RE GM. So IB times beta force cancel. So R input becomes minus 1 over GM is IB beta force R cancels. Minus 1 over GM over minus 1 over RE GM minus 1. Also this minus 1s will be cancelled. R input equals 1 over GM over 1 over RE GM plus 1. So let's continue. So R input simply equals 1 over GM times, here this is RE GM plus 1 over GM RE. So if we go to the upper side, this will be GM RE over 1 plus GM RE. So here, okay, 1 over GM, GM RE, so GMs will be cancelled, R input equals RE over 1 plus GM RE. Let's look at the circuits. R input, okay. What is this? I mean, what is this? Isn't it 1 over GM parallel RE? If 1 over GM, tell me what is 1 over GM parallel RE? It is RE over GM and its summation. GM RE plus 1 over GM. So it is becomes RE over GM times GM over 1 plus GM RE. So GMs cancels. The result is RE over 1 plus GM RE. So R input is simply 1 over GM parallel RE. Seeing this, just you need a little bit practice. That's it. Let's find the gain. What is gain? So here to find gain. Sorry, no, not this. Sorry. Here I will take this. This is RAC equivalent of circuit. So to find gain, tell me what is V output. It is minus RC times beta times IB here. So I know if I can tell V input in terms of IB, I am done. And we just calculated it. V input was here. Minus IB times beta force over GM. So, minus IB times beta force over GM. V input minus IB times beta force over GM. So, V input over V. V output over V input gives me my gain, and it is equals minus RC times beta times IB over minus IB times beta force over GM. So minus IBs cancel here, betas also cancel, the result will be GM RC. So this is an important result. What is the gain in common base amplifier? It is GM times RC. That's it, guys. And we will use this result a lot when we solve questions. Let me write it properly. Remember this. This is common base gain. It is positive. I mean, there is no 180 degree phase shift like in the common emitter case. Be careful. Gain is positive. Gain, when what is gain becoming negative means there is 180 degree phase shift. I mean, if gain was negative, like in the common emitter case, if you apply a signal like this, your output signal, there will be 180 degree phase shift. And your output signal will be like this. Start from here and goes here. This is your input signal, this is your V output signal. So what is left is the V output, R output. And simply again look at AC coolants of our circuit. For finding R output, remember that you should shut down the independent sources. Because why you shut down the independent sources? Because what you make here is finding R Thevenin. Again, look at here and imagine there is a load here, R load, and this is also V out, and look at here to find R. And you will make V input here short circuited for finding R Thevenin. So if you make it short circuit, then this is ground. There will be no current passing through this side. So so when you look at the circuit, this is also ground. Here ground, ground. This is ground. There will be no IB current. So beta times IB is also zero. This current will be zero. So all the currents will come So here, if we remove the V output and connect a V test voltage here, all the current will pass through RC. There will be no IB current. So my output resistance will easily be RC. Remember, in our analysis, we didn't take account the RDS value. Generally, there is an RDS here, RDS resistance, and its value equals VA over IC, early voltage divided by IC, but it is very large. I mean, if VA is 100 and IC is 1 milliampere, and this is 100k, and it's huge. RC is like 3k, 5k. You can ignore this resistance. And we generally, VA is taken infinite in the question. So we didn't take the RDS factor, but there is RDS factor, remember. We will take, we will solve questions where RDS is not, where VA infinite, early voltage is not infinite. I will give values like 50 or 100. And these times our output resistance will also be comparable to RDS. But generally, in this configuration, RC is like 3K, 5K. An RDS factor can be ignored. Thank you for listening, guys. See you later. Take care.